girls, I'm happy to be back again to take you through another subject. Yes, so teacher Sheby here, courtesy of Fountain School, I'm going to take you through environmental science today. But before we can proceed and do the lesson for today, I'd love to take you back to what we learned last time. Okay, so last time we looked at the garden tools. We looked at the garden tools where we had a shovel, we had a rake, a hoe, and a hosepipe. I'm sure you are able to remember the four garden tools that I've mentioned. So now, after looking at the garden tools, today we are going to look at another interesting topic in line with what we learned last time, which is care for garden tools. So today we are going to learn about how we can take care of our garden tools. Can anyone tell me how we take care of our garden tools? I'm sure you're already guessing. You pack them nicely. Before we can do that, I'm going to show you how we can take care of our garden tools. And for that, we are going to go outside and see how best we can take care of our garden tools. Remember, our garden tools have to be kept clean and properly. So let's go outside and see what we can do.
Here we are. As you can see, I'm holding one of the garden tools. I'm sure you're already guessing, okay, that's a garden fork. Yes, you're right, this is a garden fork. And remember, we're talking about how we can take care of our garden tools. So I'm going to show you how we can take care of the garden tools. So here, as you can see, I have a bucket here, and in this bucket there's water. I'm sure you're able to see water. I have water in the bucket. So what we're going to do here is we are going to wash our garden tools. So you can either get, it could be a bucket, or it could be a dish that you're comfortable with, or you can use a tap, meaning you can get to use direct water. So observe what I'm going to do on how best I'm going to take care of the garden tools. So I'm going to start with a garden fork, see what I'm doing. So here, as you can see, I'm washing my garden fork. It is always important to leave our garden tools clean, okay, so that our tools do not easily get damaged. So here we go. I've cleaned my garden fork. I put it aside. Next, I have a hoe. I'm going to do the same to the hoe. I'm going to clean it. I'm going to clean the hoe. See how I'm cleaning it? I also have to clean it on the other side. As you clean, you have to make sure all the dirty is out. Okay, so next I'm going to get a shovel. Okay, as you can see, it looks very dirty. So even with this one, I'm going to wash it. Now see, if you so wish, if you want, when you're cleaning the garden tools, you can even get anything that you feel comfortable with to use as you clean. Like for me, I'm okay using my hands. That's why I'm using my hands to clean. Make sure all the dirty is out. So, there we go. Okay, so I'll also keep it up. So, let me clean my hands. As you can see here, I've cleaned my garden fork. My garden fork, my hoe, and the shovel. You must be wondering, but why has teacher put them there? I need to make sure that the garden tools are dry. Remember, you should not pack your garden tools before they dry. Make sure after drying, then you take them where you keep your garden tools. It could be in the house. Some of you have specific rooms where you put the garden tools. Only after they've dried can you take them there. So for now, we are going to wait for our garden tools to dry, then we'll come and pack them later. So we can now get back to class and continue with our lesson.
Okay, so as you observed, I was washing the garden tools. What was I washing? To make sure that the garden tools look nice. Even as I pack them, they won't look dirty. Imagine if I'm using the garden tools, it could be you are cleaning your vegetable garden or the flower garden, then you leave them dirty. No. So I'm going to give you a task. If Auntie or Mommy is cleaning, including yourself, if you do help out cleaning the gardens, make sure after cleaning the garden, you take care of the garden tools the way you saw teacher doing it in the video. So now next what you're going to do is, we are going to write the title here. So we're going to write our title here, which is Care of Care of Garden Tools. So, what you're going to do here, observe what teacher is going to do. I'm going to draw how we can take care of our garden tools. Remember, I said not only can you use a tap to clean your garden tools, you can also use a bucket of water, as you saw, also a dish, a comfortable dish where you can put in your garden tools. So here, I'm going to draw something. I'm sure you're wondering, what is teacher drawing? Okay, so next, I'm going to put out the drawings. I'm sure you're guessing, teacher is doing what? Yes. So, here, I'm going to draw a garden fork. Apart from a garden fork, I'm going to put hair oil, and apart from your oil, I'm going to put a shovel. Okay, so and I can draw a better one than teacher. So I'm looking forward to seeing your good drawings. I like the ones teacher is doing here. Okay, so after that, remember there's one thing that you're supposed to use when you're cleaning the garden tools. Outside, I told you, so here, teacher is going to put water. Teacher is going to put it. So, the water has to be enough so that the garden tools that you're cleaning are washed properly. So, what you are seeing here is how we can take care of our garden tools. And this we are calling it washing. So down here, I'm going to put washing. So you need to wash your garden tools after using. Always remember, your garden tools should be kept clean. When the garden tools are kept clean, it will be easier for you to use them. You won't have trouble using your garden tools. So for today, we are looking at care for garden tools. And I took you through how best you can clean your garden tools. We went outside to clean our garden tools at the tap. And here I've also drawn another way we can take off our garden tools by means of using, it could be a dish or a bucket. And here, this is a dish. You can use a dish to get water, then you clean your garden tools. So, what I expect of you is, you're going to first copy the date. After copying the date, you're going to write the title. After writing the title, you are going to draw how we take care of the garden tools, which is washing. And thereafter, teacher expects to see the good drawings in your book so that she can mark and put stars where possible. So, for now, boys and girls, this has been Teacher Sheby, courtesy of Fountain School, hoping to see you again as we do another video together. So, for now, it's a bye.